everyone. I'm physician Tan Wen Jia from Eu Yan Sang TCM Wellness Clinic at Plaza Singapura. So many patients have inquired on their condition through AskSinseh, our digital physician platform at AskSinseh.sg. And today I'm going to answer a question from one of our patients. So the question that the patient asked is that I feel lightheaded and have constipation sometimes. I also have neck and shoulder aches. What could be my problem? So in TCM's point of view, feeling lightheaded, dizzy or giddy can be due to various factors such as deficiencies in the body, phlegm dampness, tea and blood stagnation, or even reasons such as stress. So these factors affect the circulation of tea and blood to the head, which results in lightheadedness. For deficiency issues, the head is not able to get sufficient nourishment, which can cause the patient to feel giddy or dizzy as well. In some severe cases, you know, some patients may feel like the surroundings are spinning, or it causes them to lose their balance, or it triggers nausea. And so it's very important for you to avoid sudden movements, especially, you know, when you're turning your head, getting up from a chair or from the bed, or even, you know, from a squatting position. Make sure to do it slowly, because sudden change in movements or sudden change in positions are some common triggers of giddiness or dizziness. Neck and shoulder aches is also another issue that the patient mentioned, and this is actually quite common nowadays because we spend a lot of time at our desk, you know, using the computer or on our mobile phones, and things like poor posture, overworking, not getting enough rest, or even stress can cause tension to build up in the neck and shoulders, resulting in like aches and pains. At the same time also, neck and shoulder aches can also affect the circulation to the head as well, causing giddiness or even reasons such as headaches. So sometimes like headaches, dizziness can be related to tension in the neck and shoulders also. In general, if the dizziness is not triggered by head and neck movements, light stretching exercises is recommended to help to relieve the tension in the area. So make sure you maintain a good posture as well when you're at work, you're not slouching forward, or you know that the computer is at an eye level, and get up every 1 to 2 hours if possible to try to stretch and relieve the tension in the area. The last symptom that the patient mentioned was about constipation, and that can be due to deficiencies in the body like a tea deficiency, blood deficiency, poor digestive function, or excess syndromes like excess heat due to taking in too much heaty foods, not getting enough water, or tea stagnation as well. So diet is very important in maintaining healthy bowel movements. In general, make sure to take enough fluids and also enough fiber. So that means taking in sufficient fruits and vegetables. Try to avoid anything that's too greasy or spicy, and also raw and cold foods. So this includes like salads and sashimis, because they can impair the digestive system as well. So some easy massages that, you know, people who struggle with constipation can do is, one is just rubbing the abdomen in a circular clockwise motion, and another one is an acupoint on the hand. So just 4 fingers above the crease of the wrist and then in between the 2 bones. So you can just knead the acupoint for about 2 minutes, and that will help with constipation issues as well. So a consultation with a TCM physician can help in understanding the condition better, you know, asking more questions, we have a look at the tongue and also do a pulse reading, and then recommend suitable treatments like herbal medication, acupuncture, or even cupping depending on what you need. So that was our AskSinseh Q&A today. A gentle reminder that this is just general advice because everyone's body condition is different, and we would encourage you to seek help from a physician to understand, you know, more about your condition and get a detailed diagnosis. You may visit our website at sg.yuansangclinic.com to book your appointment, or call our Yuansang Clinic directly if you prefer a teleconsultation. Also, if you have any other questions, please feel free to post them on AskSinseh.sg, and we will get back to you as soon as possible. So thank you for watching, and see you next time.